وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد وإن شرح of the كتاب أخلاق حملة القرآن written by الإمام أبو بكر محمد بن الحسين الآجري رحمه الله The author رحمه الله he said وقال تعالى الله سبحانه وتعالى he said وكذلك أنزلناه and like that we sent down the Qur'an عربياً we sent it down in the Arabic language وصرفنا فيه and in the Qur'an Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala he says we changed the methods and the approaches in how we conveyed the message of warning the people. وصرفنا الله تبارك وتعالى التصريف means to change and alternate. فيه من الوعيد the warnings. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala he changed the أساليب الوعيد, the forms in which he used subhanahu wa ta'ala to warn the people. Sometimes Allah tabarak wa ta'ala he warns them بالتهديد والتخويف. He threatens them subhanahu wa ta'ala. And at times he places fear in their hearts. And times he does other ways subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why does Allah do that? لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَّقُونَ So they can come with taqwa. So they can attain taqwa from all of this. Mentioning taqwa in the context of وَصَرَّفْنَا فِيهِ مِنَ الْوَعِيدِ is to show you that taqwa means al-wiqaya, is to take a prevention. And the person takes a prevention from the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The uquba and the iqab of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala requires a shield. It requires from the person to take a shield to protect themselves from that punishment. And also to be fearful and to take the preventative measures for the day which you're going to return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the hellfire which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared for the oppressors and the wrongdoers. أَوْ يُحْدِثُ لَهُمْ ذِكْرًا Allah mentions the second reason why He changes the methods and the forms in which He warns them. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala mentions the second reason which is أَوْ يُحْدِثُ لَهُمْ ذِكْرًا Or it can renew for them. Yuhdith means, ihdath means to renew. It's going to be a renewal for them every single time they hear a different verse. And you're being prevented from the same thing, but the method is different. It's going to feel like it's a new prevention. So it's going to be a new reminder for you. So it's going to aid in your listening skills and your contemplating and your pondering over the verses. That's what it's going to do. Al-Allama Abdul Razzaq ibn Abdul Muhsin al-Abbad, he said, أَوْ يُحْدِثُ لَهُمْ ذِكْرًا He says, أَيْ تَغَيُّرًا وَصَلَاحًا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَالْإِقَامَةِ عَلَىٰ طَاعَتِهِ It will renew in you and it will change your affairs by allowing you to go towards that which is in the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and also in the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then al-Imam al-Aajurri rahimahullah he said, ثُمَّ إِنَّ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى وَعَدَ لِمَنِ اسْتَمَعَ إِلَىٰ كَلَامِهِ فَأَحْسَنَ الْأَدَبَ عِنْدَ اسْتِمَاعِهِ بِالْإِعْتِبَارِ الْجَمِيلِ ولزوم الواجب باتباعه والعمل به أن يبشره عز وجل منه بكل خير ووعده على ذلك أفضل الثواب فقال تعالى فبشر عباد الَّذِينَ يَسْتَمِعُونَ الْقَوْلَ فَيَتَّبِعُونَ أَحْسَنَهُ أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ هَدَاهُمُ اللَّهُ وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمْ أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ. The author, rahimahullah, he said, ثُمَّ and إِنَّ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى وَعَدَ, Allah promises, subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah made a promise. لِمَنِ اسْتَمَعَ إِلَىٰ كَلَامِهِ, to the person who listens to the speech of Allah. Allah made a promise, subhanahu wa ta'ala, to whoever listens to his speech. فَأَحْسَنَ الْأَدَبَ, and the person makes sure that when he listens to the speech of Allah, that he perfects his manners and his etiquettes. He makes sure. عِنْدَ اسْتِمَاعِهِ, when listening to the Qur'an, your manners and your etiquettes is high. And it's good when you're listening to the Qur'an. Allah made a promise to these people. بِالِعْتِبَارِ الْجَمِيلِ وَلُزُومِ الْوَاجِبِ بِالْتِبَاعِ. How do they come with good manners? The way that they could come with good manners when they listen to the Qur'an is that they take those beautiful reminders on board. And they uphold the obligatory things that the Qur'an is instructing them. They uphold that. They do it. They come with it. وَالْعَمَلِ بِهِ, and they implement the Qur'an. أَنْ يُبَشِّرَهُ مِنْهُ بِكُلِّ خَيْرٍ. And the thing that Allah promised them, subhanahu wa ta'ala, is all types of good for these people. That, يعني, these people, when they listen to the Qur'an, they uphold particular manners. And they come with particular etiquettes. And what are those etiquettes that they come with? The etiquettes that they come with is these reminders. They make sure that they apply it on themselves. They also make sure that the obligatory things that the Qur'an is instructing and the things that the Qur'an is saying is obligatory, they're making sure that they follow it. What is going to be for these people? All types of good is going to be for them. Now I want you to ponder here. The author, rahimahullah, is saying these people are going to get glad tidings. And the glad tidings that they're going to get is all good. And Allah is going to give them all of the good there is. Okay. وَوَعَدَهُ عَلَى ذَلِكَ أَفْضَلَ الثَّوَابِ. And Allah tabarak wa ta'ala promised them, He promised them that عَلَى ذَلِكَ أَفْضَلَ الثَّوَابِ, that is going to give them in the greatest form of reward. فَقَالَ تَعَالَى. Now the author needs to bring his evidence. Evidence for what, brothers and sisters? The evidence is for a person is listening to the Qur'an. They are pondering on the Qur'an. They are making sure that these verses that they are reading or these verses that they're listening to, they are following it. They're implementing it in their life. They're adhering to it. These people, all of good is for them. Now the author is going to bring his evidence for that. فَقَالَ تَعَالَى, Allah said, فَبَشِّرْ عِبَادِ, give glad tidings to my slaves. Give glad tidings to my slaves. الَّذِينَ يَسْتَمِعُونَ الْقَوْلَ, the ones that hear the speech. فَيَتَّبِعُونَ, and they follow أَحْسَنَهُ, the best of it. أُولَٰئِكَ, those who have just been mentioned. Which ones? The ones who are listening to the best of speech. And when they listen to the speech and they follow the best of it, أُولَٰئِكَ, those ones are الَّذِينَ هَدَاهُمُ اللَّهِ, they are the ones Allah guided. وَأُولَٰئِكَ, and those people are هُمْ أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ, they are the wise ones. Ponder here. The author said something to us and then he brought evidence for it. We have to learn the evidence and how the author is using it, rahimahullah. The author told us before he brought the ayah, he told us that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made a promise to the one who hear the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They hear the speech of Allah. And they make sure that they uphold the manners and the etiquettes required from them by listening to the speech of Allah, by making sure that we implement it in our lives, that we take it on board. The author then says, if we do that and we come with that, Allah is going to give us all good. The question here is, where did the author get that Allah is going to give us all good? How did he extract that from the verse? The way that he extracted it from is فَبَشِّرْ عِبَاد, give glad tidings to my slaves. Now Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala didn't mention in this verse the glad tidings. He didn't mention it, he withheld it. He held it back. And he never mentioned what that glad tidings is. So, because it wasn't mentioned, it encompasses all types of glad tidings. All good will fall under it. All khair, all rif'ah, all falah, all sa'adah, fi dunya wal akhirah is in there. How? Because the qa'ida according to the scholars is hadful ma'muli yu'dinul bil'umumi. Another wording, anna hadful muta'alliqi yufidul umuma. If wabashir ibad, give glad tidings to my slaves, for what? It wasn't mentioned. That's the muta'alliq, the thing that it was meant to be connected to. The glad tidings is connected to a word. The word that it was connected to is missing from the verse. The scholars, they say this shows generalization. It means that it's all of the glad tidings, all of the types of good there is, Allah is going to give it to them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. The ayah also said something else. الَّذِينَ يَسْتَمِعُونَ الْقَوْلَ, the ones who hear the speech. There are two views. One view I'm going to mention here, and the other view I'm going to bring it later, inshallah ta'ala. الَّذِينَ يَسْتَمِعُونَ الْقَوْلَ, they hear the speech. The first view is, they hear all the speeches, whether it comes from the humans or it comes from Allah. They hear both. الَّذِينَ يَسْتَمِعُونَ الْقَوْلَ, they listen to the speech. Whether that speech comes from the human, and whether it comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they hear the speech, they listen. الَّذِينَ يَسْتَمِعُونَ الْقَوْلَ. And then after, what do they do? فَيَتَّبِعُونَ أَحْسَنَ, they follow the best from them. Which is the best speech? The speech of the Creator or the creation? Which one is better? The Creator, the one who created the creation, or the speech of the creation? Without a doubt, no one is going to say that the speech of the creation is better than the speech of the Creator. No one's going to say that, right? So, فَيَتَّبِعُونَ أَحْسَنَ here means they follow the speech of Allah over the speech of the creation. They abandon the speech of the creation and they choose the best of speech. Which one is the best of speech? The speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's one tafsir of the ayah that some scholars took. فَيَتَّبِعُونَ, and they listen to all speeches and they realize that all the other speech, it is no way close to the speech of Allah. فَيَتَّبِعُونَ, and they follow أَحْسَنَهُ, the best of speech, which is the speech of Allah. أُولَٰئِكَ, those ones. Who when they listen to all of the speeches, they choose to follow the speech of Allah. أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ هَدَاهُمُ اللَّهِ, they are the ones Allah guided, subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَأُولَٰئِكَ, and they are the ones who we can refer to and we can call them أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ. أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ. أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ are what, brothers and sisters? They are أَهْلُ الْعُقُولِ الرَّاجِحَةِ, the smart people, the clever people. Some of the scholars, they extracted from this verse that the non-Muslims or the people who have abandoned the Qur'an and do not follow the Qur'an and have tossed the Qur'an over their shoulders, they cannot be referred to as a aqil. We can't call a person who has abandoned the Qur'an, who has dismissed the Qur'an, has tossed the Qur'an over their shoulders. نَبَذُوهُ وَرَاءَ ظُهُرِهِمْ, threw it over their shoulders. Don't want to hear the Qur'an. And whenever the Qur'an is recited, it annoys them. These people, they cannot be referred to as a aqil, a smart person. The most that can be said about them is صاحب الدهاء. And he's a person who knows how to buy and sell, who knows how to live his life, he knows his worldly affairs. That's the most that can be said. Lakin to give him this term, aqil, is not for him. Why? Because they, the non-Muslims, the people who have abandoned the Qur'an, ignored the Qur'an, the Day of Judgment, what are they going to say? They're going to say, وَقَالُوا لَوْ كُنَّا نَسْمَعُ أَوْ نَعْقِلُ مَا كُنَّا فِي أَصْحَابِ السَّعِيرِ فَاعْتَرَفُوا بِدَمْدِهِمْ فَسُحْقًا لِأَصْحَابِ السَّعِيرِ. They're going to say the Day of Judgment, وَقَالُوا لَوْ كُنَّا نَسْمَعُ, if we listen to the Qur'an, فَيَتَّبِعُونَ أَحْسَنَ, الَّذِي يَسْتَمِعُونَ الْقَوْلِ. If only we listen to the Qur'an. If only we pondered on the Qur'an. If only we followed the instructions that the Qur'an was given us. If only we did that. وَقَالُوا لَوْ كُنَّا نَسْمَعُ أَوْ نَعْقِلُ. أَوْ نَعْقِلُ means what? Or if we had aql. So they're saying we didn't have aql. مَا كُنَّا فِي أَصْحَابِ السَّعِيرِ. We will not be from the dwellers of the hellfire. Now it's right not to call these people aql. The reason is because what aql does a person have if they've chosen the dunya over the akhirah? أَتَسْتَبْدِلُونَ الَّذِي هُوَ أَدْنَى بِالَّذِي هُوَ خَيْرٌ. They've chosen the dunya and the glitters and the glamours of this dunya over a life that's forever going to remain. وَلِذَلِكَ الشَّيْخُ الْإِسْلَامِ Ibn Taymiyyah, he said that a twig of Jannah, it's better than this dunya and everything in it. And a twig, a little twig from Jannah, or a dust, or one sand from Jannah, one grain of sand from Jannah is better than the dunya and everything in it. You have to understand. So that person who you're referring to as smart and as clever and you're praising has chosen something less than the greater thing. What would you call a person who chose less than something higher and greater? You would say that person is not smart. He didn't know how to do something properly. So that's why we don't call these people. We don't refer to them as aqil or clever person or smart person. All that we can say, the most that we can say if we want to praise them, is to say sahibul daha. And he knows how to live his life. But if you want to be a smart person and a clever person, is the one who follows the Qur'an. The Qur'an is what you follow. It is the Qur'an that you follow. So these people, what is for them? فَبَشِّرْ عِبَادَ. Give glad tidings to my slaves. Give glad tidings to my slaves. The glad tidings here, brothers and sisters, is كُلُّ خَيْرٍ. Every good. رِفْعَةً وَفَلَاحٍ وَسَعَادَةً. في الدنيا والآخرة. In this world and in the hereafter, that's what's going to be for you, inshallah ta'ala. وقال سبحانه وتعالى الله عز وجل, he said, وَأَنِيبُوا تَانْ إِلَى رَبِّكُمْ. The author brings another ayah. وَأَنِيبُوا إِلَى رَبِّكُمْ. Turn towards your Lord. وَأَسْلِمُوا لَهُ. And surrender to him. The word وَأَنِيبُوا إِنَابَ means a rujoo. Return back to your Lord. Go back to Allah. وَأَسْلِمُوا لَهُ. And surrender to him. مِنْ قَبْلِ. Before. أَنْ يَأْتِيَكُمُ الْعَذَابُ. Before the punishment of Allah comes your way. Turn back to your Lord. وَأَنِيبُوا here means come back to your Lord in repentance. التَّوْبَةُ. النَّصُوحَ. Repent to your Lord from the wrong that you have done and the mistake that you have done, the shortcoming that has come your way. وَلِذَلِكَ. The person does repentance from two things. The two things that we repent from is we have done something we were told not to do. Something we were prohibited from, we do it. And we were told, don't do this, we did it. It requires repentance. The second thing is we left off something we were told to do. We were told, do this, and we didn't do it. We repent from those two things. وَأَنِيبُوا إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ وَأَسْلِمُوا. And surrender to him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Give all of your affairs to him. وَأُفَوِّضُ أَمْرِي إِلَىٰ اللَّهِ. Say that I surrender all my affairs to Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَأَنِيبُوا إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ وَأَسْلِمُوا لَهُ. And surrender to him. Surrender here means to believe in him as your Lord, number one. You're a slave, he's the master. That's the first thing that's needed from you. You are the creation. You are the created and he's the creator. You are the slave and he's the master. You are the worshipper and he's the worshipped. And you have to, the priorities need to be set correct. وَأَسْلِمُ. Surrender and give Allah tabarak wa ta'ala his rights. مِنْ قَبْلِ. Before أَنْ يَأْتِيَكُمُ الْعَذَابُ. Or a punishment is going to come your way. The scholars, they say that the punishment comes when the person doesn't come with these two characteristics. الْإِنَابَ وَالْإِسْتِسْلَامِ. If you do not come with inaba, turning back to Allah for repentance and forgiveness, and also You do not come with surrendering. Allah will bring your way a punishment. Those punishments, my beloved brothers and sisters, it comes in different ways. It can sometimes be a virus that strikes the people, that causes pain and agony and suffering. It can cause and bring about harm to the economy. It can cause harm to the people's safety and their well-being. It can even cause harm to the people's mindset and their mental health. Adab. ولذلك if you look at the ayah, Allah says, ظهر الفساد في البر والبحر بما كسبت أيدي الناس. Allah has brought about, sorry, the people have brought about and they've done mischief on this earth, on the sea and on the earth and everywhere. Corruption, harm, cheating, lying, disobedience of Allah, idol worshipping, following our whims and desires has been done on every part of the earth. صح? At the ending of the ayah, Allah تبارك وتعالى, what does he say? لعلهم يرجعون. رجوع. Which is what? الإيمان, الإنابة. It is to turn up to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All of this. ظهر الفساد في البر والبحر بما كسبت أيدي الناس ليذيقهم بعض الذي عملوا لعلهم يرجعون. So they can turn back to the Lord. الإنابة. The whole reason why all of this is done is return back to Allah. وأنيبوا إلى ربكم. وأسلموا and surrender to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. من قبل before أن يأتيكم العذاب before the punishment comes to you. ثم لا تنصرون and you're not going to receive no victory. No one's going to help you. If Allah has forsaken you, who can help you? Who can help you after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? No one. Allah is going to forsake you and there is no one who's going to help you. ثم لا تنصرون and you're not going to receive no victory. Then Allah says, وَاتَّبِعُوا follow. أَحْسَنَ مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكُمْ the best that has been sent unto you. وَاتَّبِعُوا follow. أَحْسَنَ the best of that which has been sent unto you. So does that mean the Qur'an has parts of it which is best? A part of the Qur'an which is better than another part? Can we say that the Qur'an, there's a part which is not good and there's a part which is good? Can we say that? وَاتَّبِعُوا أَحْسَنَ مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكُمْ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ Allah then says, وَاتَّبِعُوا أَحْسَنَ مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكُمْ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ مِنْ قَبْلِ follow the best that has been sent to you from your Lord, مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ مِنْ قَبْلِ before أَنْ يَأْتِيَكُمُ الْعَذَابُ before the punishment comes to you بَغْتَةً suddenly you're not even expecting it to come. بَغْتَ means فَجْأَ unexpected. A punishment of Allah comes. وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَشْعُرُونَ and you are unaware of what's going to happen. You don't know anything that's going to take place and it all happens suddenly. So here the ishkal here to some people is وَاتَّبِعُوا أَحْسَنَ. In English this is called a superlative. And in Arabic it's called سِيَغُ الْمُبَالَغَ أَحْسَنْ أَفْضَلْ. These are superlatives. The best of which has been sent down on you. This is the second tafsir of the ayah, الَّذِينَ يَتَّبِعُونَ الَّذِينَ, sorry, الَّذِينَ يَسْتَمِعُونَ الْقَوْلَ. That some of the scholars, the ayah, فَبَشِّرْ عِبَادْ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَمِعُونَ الْقَوْلَ. I mentioned one view. The second view some scholars took, that the word الَّذِينَ يَسْتَمِعُونَ الْقَوْلَ here means the Qur'an. So if we say الَّذِينَ يَسْتَمِعُونَ الْقَوْلَ فَيَتَّبِعُونَ أَحْسَنَ, it means that the Qur'an has an ahsan. Just like this verse, وَاتَّبِعُوا أَحْسَنَ مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكُمْ. So it's ishkal here. This ishkal, inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to respond to it in my next episode, بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ الْكَرِيمِ. May Allah reward you all for listening to this, بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ الْكَرِيمِ. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me, shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أستغفرك وأتوب إليه.
Assalamu alaikum. If you're enjoying these videos and you'd like to keep up to date with all of the courses we're going to be running, make sure you head over to amauathome.com.